is pure theater!
History about to be made. That's Mei Yamaguchi. That's Angela Lee. And this is for the inaugural one championship Atomweight world title. Fight. Brought to you by G-Shock. Absolute toughness. Here we go.
Steve, the Lees only have one speed, and that is full tilt boogie. Can she control herself, slow it down? Because this is a five-round battle here tonight, so there's a long time to be in there. She looks composed, looks relaxed.
That straight-up style that Angela has when they're standing up exaggerates the size advantage that she has over Yamaguchi.
That was a nice little leg kick. She landed right there. She faked the right, came in with the left. Nice little tap on the inside of the leg and then lands a couple of strikes. You can see the height difference between these two. So there's definitely going to be a reach there for Angela. How is she going to utilize that?
Will Yamaguchi force Lee to show us what she has in her fists? Hasn't had the opportunity, hasn't needed to demonstrate her punching power yet. We can't say she doesn't have it. She just hasn't shown it to us. 1 minute down. This is a five-round contest, 5 minutes away.
Angela Lee has finished all of her opponents in double fast time, and Mei Yamaguchi has never been finished. So somebody's always about to go.
Low center of gravity Yamaguchi has. You can see she's strong.
Inside in the clinch, and you gotta think once this fight gets to the ground, that innovative ground game of Angela Lee is gonna show dominance, but Yamaguchi is so technically sound on the ground. She's never been finished.
She takes a good left hook to the head there.
In 24 fights, she's never been finished, so it's gonna be really hard. She's really tough, got that samurai spirit.
Will Angela Lee be the first person to finish her? Five rounds, will it go that far? We're 2 minutes into this contest. 12,000 fans in Singapore looking at a bit of history. Significant moment in one championship history, this.
Nice little knee landed in there. Head kick, caught the kick, but it did connect halfway.
She wasn't quite as crisp with that kick as she needed to be.
Angela Lee jumps guard and reverses it to mount. That was beautiful.
Fans are going nuts here in Singapore.
They knew exactly what they saw there. Possible guillotine here. She's got the arm under the neck, but see how she keeps her head real high? She's got to keep that up there. It's a real dangerous position to be in.
Showed good strength to get back on her feet, but straight into the guillotine. But as you say, she's up nice and high. That prevents the leverage, the torque Angela needs to really use this and convert it into a finishing move. Yamaguchi has the presence of mind to dig in a right hand to the body and work something of her own.
She's in a dangerous position right here. She's got the arm outside. You know, so it's very deep right here. She's got to do the right thing. She's got to put her head down. This is a bad position. She's got the body triangle. This is deep, Steve.
The body triangle's just stopping her from moving.
Now she's a little bit high. She's a little bit twisted. She might not have it, but Mei's tough. She's never been finished, but she's cranking on it.
Look out. Olivia Costa is so close. He's primed. He's ready to call it over. But that tap hasn't come.
You can see the side of her neck right there is exposed, so it's more of a neck crank. She's more cranking on the neck this way.
This is a tiring move to hold for too long, though, Mitch, isn't it?
Yeah, you have to. That's experience. You have to know when to let go and when to just not gas out your arms. There is another 21 minutes left in this fight, so it's very, very important that she doesn't, but she might really believe in this. She's got this in there.
1 minute left in this round, though. It's a long time. Looks like she's just slipping out of it, does it? It's a tough one.
You could have the, it's really tough to tell what Mei's feeling, but she's looking like she's trying to pull her head
out. The strain on Angela's face.
Not really the best way to go. Angela looks like she's really putting a lot into it. You know, she's trying to adjust. Good adjustment there by Mei. How she just stepped over that leg. Now she's out of the danger zone.
Digging in the punches to the side of the body. How tired will Angela Lee be now, having held that for close to a minute? Angela Lee slips out. Sorry, Mei Yamaguchi slips out, lands a punch.
There's
now it's about how tired Angela might be. Armbar possibility.
Yeah, but she knows what she's doing. She immediately got that arm away from the crotch. The elbow came up.
Heel to the face. We're in the final 5 seconds. This round has just raced by.
You've got to wonder what kind of energy she has after holding that position for more than 2 minutes. She was tempting that submission.
I think we're looking at Mei Yamaguchi's sister here on the left, just behind the Japanese flag. Can you imagine what they're feeling? The tension, the possibility that that fight could have been over in the first round, but how tired will Angela be? That was almost a minute, Mitch, holding that.
Yeah, Steve, once the fight goes to the ground, you never know. There's that beautiful transition. She jumped guard, pulled her into guard, and then ended up in mount with a beautiful transition. But that's the thing, you never know what to expect when Angela gets on the ground. The Lee family is so innovative when it comes to these submissions, and it's a threat from anywhere.
Mei Yamaguchi, she'll have heard, she'll have read about Angela Lee and the crazy things she does, the innovative way she goes about her game. She may well take something from the fact that she got out of that position and she survived it and she's into the second round. Let's see what she can do with it. That is what's on the line. A glimmering golden, silver, ruby studded ONE Championship world title belt. Second round.
Nice little confidence boost for me. Yamaguchi, she got out of the first round, defended some good submissions. But Angela's definitely in the lead because she had, you know, control. Nice little 1-2. Her punching looks sharp, and especially when she has that reach advantage that she has to utilize.
Big high guard Angela has.
Elbows are a little wide, so it leaves her vulnerable to body kicks.
Oh, she got that leg up nice and high. Caught Angela Lee on the jaw.
You know, Mei is a third degree
black belt. Big right hand from Yamaguchi.
Nice.
Came swinging in. There was no hook to it at all. It was a straight overhand, almost bolo punch that caught Angela. But she's worked her way into possible trouble here as they swivel around.
Nice little outside trip to end up on the bottom as Mei is the one that reverses this one and ends up on top. Mei Yamaguchi has no fear of going to the ground with Angela Lee.
What can she do from this position, Mitch? Just trying to establish leg control there, aren't they?
Well, you can see how Angela's elevating the leg there. She's back into full guard. You know, the half guard position where you only have both legs wrapped around one leg, and when you're in the top, a lot of people are preferring the ground and pound.
She's less likely to go for the submission than Angela would in this position. She's after the punches, the ground and pound, but she's pulled in nice and close. And this is where it gets difficult to land those punches because there's no distance between them, no leverage to land that punch.
Yeah, it really neutralizes the height advantage that Angela Lee has. You know, when they're on the ground like this, you know, you can use the long limbs or the long arms to slip in chokes, but it really nullifies any height and reach advantage that you have when the fight gets onto the ground. Everybody's almost the same size when it gets to the ground. Mei's on top now, landing shots. You gotta be wondering, what's Angela thinking as far as the submissions that are coming? See how she opens her guard? She's not closing the guard. When the guard is closed, you're kind of locking the person into position. But when the guard's open, you're thinking about submissions. See how she immediately starts throwing up her legs. She's starting to think, going for arm bars, going for triangles, setting up sweeps. There it is. Just like that, she threw the leg over the head. Now there's a possible arm bar there. It's an awkward position. The arm is bent, so.
Crowd are really, really into this, aren't they? The arm bar's still very much there.
Yes, look at that. Look at that. She just toughs it out, pulls it out.
She doesn't look troubled at all.
It's high, though. Now she's in there.
She's got tremendous strength, though. This doesn't look too much of a problem for her.
When you're up in the air like that, you can't really crank your hips. You can't really pull them into position. But there's that sweep that we were talking about earlier tonight where you grab the feet and pull them down to the ground. Mei's back up. and pops right back up into the clinch.
The fans are just going wild on their feet, applauding behind us. You know, I was saying we haven't seen Angela Lee demonstrate the power of her punch. We also haven't seen much about how she can take a punch. I think Yamaguchi is going to test that tonight. She's come close already. Ground and pound looks the danger zone for Angela.
Angela Lee there with like the sacrifice throw. She threw, basically she got the clinch and she just kind of threw Yamaguchi on top. So she's definitely feeling much more comfortable when she's on her back. You know, you can see her threatening, you know, she immediately locks that hand into position, right, to nullify any punches that are coming. But then also when you hook the hands, you can start throwing your legs up for arm bars and triangles.
Angela's left hand controlling both of Yamaguchi's hand for a while, leaving the right elbow to just land shots at will. That changed, of course, pretty quickly. There's up punches there from Angela. But it's Yamaguchi on top. Is this surprising to you, Mitch? 9 minutes into this contest? Armbar again, perhaps?
That's it. And look at that. Mei just stands up, rips it out.
Oh, good, nice little hand. Angela was hurt by that.
Yeah, Steve, I am not surprised at all. That's why I'm saying people are underestimating, you know, that 73% that had the Facebook poll, you know, we're thinking Angela Lee is going to win. They're underestimating how legit and talented Yamaguchi is.
She has never been stopped in 24 professional fights. Never been stopped.
Look at that cradle. She grabs the leg, grabs the arm, and just controls her. In Mei's decision losses, she's been out grappled. And Angela is getting up these positions. You know, she's ending up possible. There's a choke. There's a choke of some sort, a possible guillotine. Good round for Yamaguchi.
Well, they're on their feet behind us here. It was hard for Mitch to keep up with exactly what was going on. A choke of some sort, it certainly was. She had her in trouble, there's no question. Mei Yamaguchi, if you weren't expecting much from her, I think you're now seeing how wrong you were.
Nice, she attempted the guillotine there. Angela tried to roll, and you can see how she laces up those legs, trapping Angela in position. The Singaporean crowd is very well acknowledged. They are so experienced. I mean, Singapore is turning into the Mecca of Asian mixed martial arts here. And so this crowd knows exactly what's going on. Each of these transitions, beautiful techniques by both girls.
From Singapore, Mitch, around 75 countries around the world seeing this, potentially 1 billion viewers. That's the reach, that's the interest that this fight, this inaugural Women's World Atomweight Championship in the one championship cage, that's the attention it's getting. These two women seemingly with the world at their feet. Who will come out with that glittering belt? 10 minutes down, 15 to go.
Ready?
Judges will score this fight in its entirety. It's not round by round. You don't get one round in the
ball. Oh,
what a big punch! Angela Lee in huge trouble from that overhand right that we signaled before the fight started. That's her big, big weapon. And Angela Lee has just tasted it. She has the presence of mind, though, to hold her hands around Yamaguchi's neck and pull her in, closing that distance.
What a shot by Yamaguchi. And immediately Angela clinches it, keeps her wits about her, and goes for the tight guard to regain some composure. Now Yamaguchi is past her guard, and she's in side control. This is a bad position. Angela's still got to be rocked from that huge shot. She easily steps over into mount.
Round and pound now. A bucking bronco. Angela Lee tries to catapult her off, but it's a high eye position. The hammer blows come down, but Angela struggles.
Armbar, that's it. It's
oh,
all
a transition.
Deep. She's got to make sure she transitions. She can't let that thumb go up. If the thumb starts to go up, it's deep. Oh, she's got to fight it. She's got to roll. Steve, that's deep. That's a deep armbar. Angela seems okay. Her arm is bending the wrong way, Steve.
She's not
but
tapping.
But she toughs it out.
Oh, my, the strength. This crowd is going crazy. The resolve from this woman. She's got out of it.
Oh, she transitions into the back. Rear naked choke, possibly, but Mei looks okay. She's giving up the mount, though.
What a round this is. Have you seen a minute and a half like this ever before in your life?
Steve, to keep that composure, to keep that control, to keep the will alive, she was dropped by a big shot. Potential armbar almost snapped her arm in two, and now she's in top.
Back and forth.
Thrown off, but she's back on top.
There's just no form. There's no form to grasp onto, is there? It's back and forth, swings and roundabouts. These two, tremendous entertainment for everyone here. I'm just looking around at the fans and we're all gasping for breath.
Steve, this is a shocker. Everybody in here is completely surprised at what is happening. Angela still has that will, that warrior spirit to keep pushing through. She's trying. Oh. She is proving she has a heart of a champion. Oh, it's a deep armbar again.
Another armbar attempt.
Don't roll over on your back. She's got to stay up. Oh, see, now she see how the thumb's down. The thumb's down. She's out of trouble, but she's given up top position. Here come the punches.
Angela will look to pull her in close again to negate the value of those punches. Oh, Matt Hume, arrange a rematch now, please.
Look at that. She easily gets back into position. Good scrambling. You know, Mei is ending up on top. Knee bar drops into the knee bar. This is a bad position. Oh, it's okay. She's out. That's the exactly thing to do. You want to negate that bar. Go belly over, roll onto the side. Look at this. These transitions are ridiculous, Steve. Now she's possibly attacking the leg again. She's trying to dive under to roll out. Angela's on top.
1:45 left in this second round. You can barely pause for breath.
Up kick. Angela looking for that same sort of Darce choke right there that her brother got the victory with earlier today. See, you can see her clinching. She's got to work that hand up into the bicep to lock that in there. That's what she's doing.
It Mei well need that kind of ingenuity.
See, now, oh, look at that. Beautiful technique by Mei. She grabs the leg to prevent the leg from lacing up and keeping her in position. Oh, knees to the head.
Using every single opportunity she can, Angela Lee, to gain an advantage. Knees to the head are damaging, damaging blows. Final minute of this third round. What a contest we're seeing here in Singapore.
That's the same submission her brother won earlier tonight. It's that Darce choke. She's rolling. There's the roll. Now she's got to hook the leg. So she's got to take those legs and hook it. It'll lock in the choke. She's got 45 seconds. How tough is Mei Yamaguchi? Oh, it's broken. And she fights out of it again.
Tremendous resolve. What guts these women have, but also what technique.
There's a possible guillotine, modified, odd position sort of thing going on here.
I think I see what you're saying. 25 seconds left in this third round.
She's got to establish the position before attempting that submission. So Mei ends up on top. This is a very critical 15 seconds. This has been a back and forth round. What's that, a diamond cutter? What is that, like a WWE move? She's attempted there.
Mei still punching for all she can into the midriff of Angela Lee as the third round comes to an end. And I think we could all be grateful that there is more to come.
Oh, there's that big right hand.
That was just huge.
That dropped Angela Lee. And then Mei jumps on her and starts pounding on her. She gets into mount.
Look, credit for the punch, but credit for taking it and
taking
making
the punch,
through the round.
Getting dropped. Getting it caught in a deep arm bar where this could have been it. A lot of people would have given up right here, but no, Angela Lee came back and actually had some very significant submission attempts in that round. But due to the big almost knockout versus the almost submissions, I don't even know how many possible submissions we had in that round.
These women have rubber arms and blistering fist. What a right hand that was from Mei Yamaguchi, 33 years old. Remember, she's never been stopped. Well, she's done more than survive 15 minutes with Angela Lee here. We have potentially another 10 minutes to come. Thereafter, somebody, Mitch, will have that world championship belt strapped around their waist. Who's ahead so far?
After three rounds, almost knocked out, big drop with that punch. I got to give a slight advantage to Yamaguchi.
Long way
after the 15 minutes, but now we're in the championship rounds. Now, Yamaguchi has been, you know, into these deep rounds. You know, she's fought some tough people.
Remember her experience, how seasoned she is. Oh, good trip from Lee. We're back down on the deck. But these two will work at every moment to improve their position. To transition from a point of vulnerability to a point of advantage.
This is uncharted territory, I think, for both these women. I might be wrong, but Yamaguchi has never, you know, seen the fourth
certainly
round.
Angela Lee.
Possible ankle lock here. You know, she's attempted the heel hook. You know, she's rolling with it. Yamaguchi's going to do the right thing. Interlaces the legs. You know, she's got to turn. She's got to try to get out of that. Looks like she's out of danger. There's a possible heel hook where you kind of just interlace the arm, like the hook of your arm, inside the ankle, and you kind of crank on the knee ligaments here. This is a very dangerous game that they're playing right here.
Impervious to leg locks and arm bars, though, Mei Yamaguchi.
24 fights, never been finished, even. She's given up the back, but she's okay with it. You know, she just kind of rolls over.
Contest this
arm triangle possibly here. You know, she's answering the phone, how she kind of puts her hand up by the, yeah, this is it. This is an arm triangle. I think she's going to have to put Yamaguchi to sleep if she wants to finish this. Mei Yamaguchi's got to keep her hand, you know, close to her ear and try to pry some space away because Angela's in mount. Now she's going to jump to the side and kind of work her way around. That's an arm triangle. We saw it with Hodger Gracie earlier.
She's scooting around, trying to get the best position she can to make it as tight as possible. I don't see Yamaguchi tapping ever.
Yeah, you know, she's doing the right thing. Now her arms, she's kind of out of danger. You know, she's trying to push on the arm.
She's pushing it.
But Angela's in the right spot. You know, she's completely into side control. That arm's deep. You know, you gotta wonder what's gonna happen here.
Olivier Cost is primed, ready to pounce and separate these two if he thinks the fight's over. Oh, she comes back
see,
with that, punches.
She's not tapping, you know,
that's
those
what
punches.
She's saying. I'm still alive, ref, I'm still here.
You know, usually some of the fighters give us a thumbs up, yeah. But yep, she's
no,
fine.
Don't you dare call it on my behalf. I'm still in this. And
she overpowers her and end up on top. Angela could take the back here, but her arm's kind of in a precarious sort of odd position. Uh-oh, there's a triangle here. If she can stuff her arm.
Got a long way to go with that, though, to get that all the way around.
No, she's just got to hook her foot with that leg. That's all she's got to do is push that arm down, and there it
oh,
is.
Oh, now she switched it.
Beautiful.
That's a much better position for her. She changed legs, saw the opening, and transitioned double quick time.
She's hooking that leg. Now she's coming over onto the side. That's a deep triangle, Steve.
Yamaguchi's throat has taken so much punishment and torque in this contest.
Will Angela Lee capture the Women's World Championship and be the first person to stop Mei Yamaguchi here with that triangle? But she's kind of out. It's I don't know how deep that is.
She just seems to generate enough space to just survive, doesn't she, in these locks?
That's also another thing about being compact like she is.
Yeah.
Look at she fights out.
Tremendous effort. She's done it to the applause of everybody here at cage side.
Takedown, ends up on top. Some punches, she's got a minute left to work here.
Entering the final 60 seconds of round four. The championship rounds, we're well into them. And we're thoroughly enjoying them. 75 countries around the world tuning into this.
That's a lot of submission attempts. This round has been all Angela Lee. And maybe enough to edge her into the lead as far as the scoring is concerned. She jumps into the guillotine, but you gotta wonder, at what point does she go, okay, I'm gonna stop trying for submissions and I'm gonna punch you in the face.
It's been submission attempt after submission attempt, and Mei Yamaguchi is just not gonna give any ground. She seems to find that gap to give her a little bit of wiggle room to survive. There's no way she's gonna tap. This pace, though, from both women is relentless.
But the thing is they're constantly pushing. They're constantly going forward. They're, you know, this is the true epitome of world championship grappling right here, that they're both consistently working. And this might be enough to move Angela Lee ahead in the scoring. We might have two rounds each. And
just, it's just because of so many submission attempts.
Yeah, I mean, they're still attacking. Even if on your back, you know, the way that, you know, one championship scores fights is that attempted submissions are, you're showing you are actively progressing the finish. And that round was clearly Angela Lee's. Here she goes.
Is a young woman. She's 19 years old. She's facing a seasoned prodigy who's 33 into the fifth round. Uncharted territory for Lee.
Uncharted territory for both women. And we don't judge fights round by round. You know, so it's not like it's 2-2 or it's, you know, it's very close. It's all about this fifth round. Who wants it more? Who is gonna push forward and capture the first ever world championship here in the women's division?
That whistle signals that the seconds need to get out of the cage and leave just the referee and our two world title contenders for the final 5 minutes of this inaugural one championship world atomweight title at the Singapore Indoor Stadium in front of 12,000 very appreciative fans all on their feet and applauding as these women face the final lap.
This is it, Steve. You gotta wonder who's gonna reach inside of themselves and find that special moment, that little burst that they need to catapult them into worldwide fame. If Angela Lee comes away, it's her destiny. It's what she was born to do. If Yamaguchi does it, then she shocks the world and becomes the one championship women's atomweight champion.
Taking some encouragement from the way she started that third round with that huge right hand. She started there with a left, right, left. Knowing that perhaps she has the advantage in the stand-up. If she can get inside that longer reach of Angela Lee, as she did then with a stiff jab, then she might be able to do some damage. Because when they've gone downstairs, the pattern has been submission attempts from Lee, survived by Yamaguchi, but the point scoring in that scenario surely goes Lee's way. Left hand from Yamaguchi, and I think she's hurt.
Yeah, Yamaguchi's looking a bit fatigued. She's not really throwing the punches with the same sort of, you know, power or emphasis.
She threw that one and backed off, didn't she? Something hurt her there, and she's starting to look perhaps a little bit tired. Knees to the body from Angela.
Angela Lee is in a prime spot. She might be sensing that little bit of weakness, that blood in the water where she's just jumping all over it. Yamaguchi's just not fighting off the same. You know, does Angela Lee have enough gas left in her tank to finish?
Women have put each other through the mill.
She's trying to take that outside leg there with the trip and drag her down to the ground where she's more comfortable, it looks.
Entering into the 23-minute mark. Left jab from Angela Lee was a good one, and I think that hurt May. She sent in a little left hand of her own without even looking at it. It was a no-look punch, and it landed.
She just left, drops right, her chin. Caution to the wind, puts it all in there, the Hail Mary.
Yeah, that's exactly what they are from Mei Yamaguchi. Right hand from her, not crisp, but it landed. A thudding kind of blow. The kick from Angela, not quite high enough. Good left
kicks.
Hand from Angela as Mei Yamaguchi came in, and down they go. The takedown.
It's been a scramble. That's been the story of this entire fight, is the scrambling.
2.5 minutes left.
Angela Lee is on the side control here as, you know, Yamaguchi's trying to bridge out of it, trying to walk along the cage to create us another scramble.
Angela has a knee on a midriff, just pinning her down there, restricting her movement, containing her ability to move around and slide away.
This could be enough. She's controlling the position. If she remains in this position, or at least on top for the next 2 minutes, we could see Angela Lee capture the one championship title. She's got a possible triangle here. She stepped over the leg there, but she's not really, doesn't really have the arm.
At the 15 minute
she doesn't
mark.
Have the arm. It's not really a triangle. It's just kind of like an uncomfortable head squeeze.
At the 15 minute mark, we may well have had Mei Yamaguchi slightly ahead. Angela Lee probably pulled herself ahead at the end of the 20 minute mark. We have 90 seconds left in this contest. Again, Olivier Coste is looking carefully, asking the question, are you ready to throw it in? I think I know the answer. Nothing's gonna stop, yeah. Nothing's gonna stop her.
There's a possible arm lock on the right side of Yamaguchi. She could threaten a possible Kimura, but the head is just cut, that triangle position that she's got on the head is just kind of holding her there and making it uncomfortable. And
even if she just continues to hold this position for the rest of the fight, surely it's one that's an advantage for Angela Lee, and the judges will see it that way. Mei Yamaguchi at the moment is only defending. Angela Lee showing her youth and probably superior cardio.
Oh, there's the arm triangle again. You know, she's doing the right thing by pushing it away. She's got 38 seconds to become the first person to finish Yamaguchi. It's there. She's still attempting the submissions and going after it.
It's a relentless assault as we enter the final 20 seconds of this contest.
That's an arm triangle right there, Steve. You can see the lips kind of going blue a little bit on Yamaguchi, but I think she's okay. She's just so tough.
She is, isn't she? There's no way she's going to cave in. She would have done that a long time ago if that was the case. Final 5 seconds of this totally enthralling contest that has been tremendous value for all of the fans here at Cadeside. The bell goes. Angela Lee walks away to a corner. Yamaguchi pulls herself off the canvas and has a little walk around to loosen her limbs. The crowd here absolutely loved what they saw. 25 minutes into it, a quick recap of the entire fight, Mitch. Who have the judges given this fight to? What do you think?
It's so close at this point, but there's another attempted submission. You know, she's got a deep arm triangle. You can see how, you know, Yamaguchi kind of creates space so that the choke's not quite deep into it. When you go for the arm triangle, you're essentially choking the person with their own arm. And it was so close, you know, but that final round, you know, could have been enough to give Angela Lee the nod, but that big knockdown, that was the most dramatic point of the entire fight.
Look
when
how,
she got hit.
Look how exhausted she is. Angela Lee put absolutely everything into that. Relentless attack, relentless submission attempts. It's so draining to hold a submission hold like some of those that she had, particularly in that second round where she just clung on. Yamaguchi was not giving up, but she kept it going. That, by the way, is Angela Lee's mom, waiting as we all are.
To present a prize for this fight, we have Mr. Takashi Tepe, Casio Singapore Assistant General Manager of Timepiece Division. Before anything else, ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for your warriors! Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all 3 judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. And now, the one women's Atomweight World Champion, Angela Twister Sister Lee!
Well, the tears were ready to flow as soon as Olivier Cost held her hand and waiting for the decision. At the moment that decision was given, the tears did flow as confetti floods the ONE Championship cage to the extent that I can no longer see what's going on therein. But let me assure you, Angela Lee is the new and first ONE Championship Women's Atomweight Champion, the first woman in ONE Championship history to be crowned a world champion. Full credit and respect to Mei Yamaguchi for putting up such an enthralling contest. Can't wait to see her back in the ONE Championship cage. But for now, it's all about celebrating the Lee family's accomplishment. And it has been a family accomplishment as the two women come together in the cage. They're both being greeted by other people, which prevents them from meeting at the moment. But all Angela Lee wants to do is embrace Mei Yamaguchi, and that's what she is doing. There it is. This is what mixed martial arts is all about.